the 2011 Triumph Thunderbird Storm carries a bigger version of the power plant found in the standard Thunderbird, in this case, a bored-out 1699cc liquid-cooled parallel twin engine, as opposed to the standard T-Bird's 1597cc mill, with a 270-degree firing interval. As you may recall, Triumph released a limited edition Thunderbird 1700 last year, basically the regular Thunderbird with the optional big bore upgrade kit installed. For the new Storm version, Triumph claims 98 horsepower at 5,200 revolutions per minute, with torque numbers of 115 feet to pound at 2,950 revolutions per minute. The Storm rumbles on the same chassis as the standard Thunderbird, with burly 47mm fork legs and adjustable twin shocks, but takes things a bit further than just an engine upgrade. To quote the Brits, it's wrapped in a pared-down, punked-up look. Loosely translated, that means it gets the iconic twin bug-eye headlights more readily found on the Rocket 3 and the Speed Triple, a straighter drag bar, and blacked engine cases. Complementing the more aggro, street rod vibe is a choice of phantom black or matte black paint. Twin 310mm floating discs up front get grabbed by four pistons for superior stomping power, and ABS is optional. Specially developed Met Sealer Marathon rubber wrapped on five-spoke alloy wheels provides the contact patch. The look may be minimalist, in the vein of, say, the Rocket 3 Roadster, but we happen to think it suits the T-Bird. Triumph has also announced changes to two other models in its cruiser category. The long-running America and Speedmaster both get major updates for 2011, including lower seat heights and improved ergonomics to make them more accessible to more riders, according to the Brits. The America's new styling takes on a more classic theme for 2011, with the 16-inch front and 15-inch rear cast wheels sporting full-height tires to complement the deep front fender, pulled-back handlebars and forward controls for a traditional low-cruiser look. The Speedmaster, meanwhile, gets more aggressive, adding a 19-inch cast aluminum front wheel with single-disc brake and skinny tire for a more chopped, hot-rod look. Ergos also get tweaked for the 2011 model year, with the low 27-inch seat height married to new, wider handlebars that bring a new riding position. The Triumph Thunderbird Storm's added performance, courtesy of using the Thunderbird's optional 1700cc big bore kit which delivers 12 more bhp and a healthy wadge of added grunt, means the Storm has the extra go to match its hot rod image, something that can't be said of the Nightsters and Black Spirits of this world. All Triumph and slick, crisp and well-built these days, and there have been no reported reliability issues with a Thunderbird, so it's fairly safe to assume the same will be true of the Thunderbird Storm.